Lucas died in the Hennepin County Jail a year and a half ago after asking repeatedly for more medical help than he was getting. More than once, crawling on the floor of his cell in pain, begging the guards and nurses for mercy. Lucas's parents and sister are suing Hennepin County tonight and demanding justice for Lucas. A warning, the video in this report is hard to watch, but Lucas's family wanted you to see it. Here's AJ Legault with the latest in his multi-year investigation, cruel and unusual.
41-year-old Lucas Bellamy writhes on the floor of the Hennepin County Jail in July of 2022 while a nurse and deputy watch.
He just watched it happen.
Colleen and Lou are Lucas's parents. Sarah? His sister. They've watched this video of Lucas during the last days of his life.
These people that were supposed to be there to help him stood there and watched him while he was crawling around, could not stand up in his cell, begging for help.
Lucas battled addictions. His family says first alcohol, then opioids. Records show he was arrested July 18th after fleeing the police with drugs in the car. When booked into the Hennepin County Jail, he said he'd swallowed some. He was taken to HCMC for monitoring. His hospital records state patient did not develop any toxic effects from possible ingestion. He was discharged back to jail with this final instruction: return to the emergency department for any new concerning symptoms.
Had any of them paid attention to the note that said send Mr. Bellamy back and complied with it, Mr. Bellamy wouldn't have died that day.
Jeff Storms is a civil rights attorney well known for his work on the George Floyd and Dante Wright cases.
This man can't stand and he's being pointed, directed back into his cell.
Today in a press conference, he announced a federal lawsuit accusing Hennepin County of indifference in Lucas's death and called for the Department of Justice to open an investigation into the jail.
Mr. Bellamy would be alive today if anyone cared enough to treat Mr. Bellamy like he was a human.
Here's what the jail video and records reveal. Bellamy began getting sick about 9 hours after returning from the hospital to jail. Vomiting, he was believed to be going through fentanyl withdrawal. He was moved to a private cell, and over the next 2 days, his symptoms worsened. By the 20th, he crawled from his cell, lying on the floor, moaning with stomach pain, saying he needed to go back to the hospital. The jail nurse took his vitals, which she said were perfectly fine, gave him Maalox and antacid, but didn't send him to the hospital. She noted of this interaction you're watching, he was able to sit up and sit still.
You see him sitting at the table, unable to hold his head up, crawling around.
Hours later, in the middle of the night, the jail's own records show, Lucas calls a guard on the intercom, screaming, "Help me, help me." The guard found him lying in the fetal position, and Lucas begged, "My stomach hurts really bad, help me." A nurse again called. Lucas told her, "I need to go to the hospital, please help me." He was sent back to his cell.
You know, the hospital was across the street.
Across the street.
It wasn't like it was really far away. And he just wanted to be seen. And, you know, it wouldn't have taken more than two tests to discern what was going on.
What was going on was Lucas had an ulcer, a lethal hole allowing his bowel contents to freely and painfully leak into his abdomen. An hour after the last visit, Lucas again asked to see the nurse, whose notes seem to indicate they think he's faking. She wrote, "Deputy walked to see him visually first. No crying, patient resting. Patient, aware that a deputy was checking on him, started to whine."
Whining. He was whining.
And when people are in pain, they whine. They moan.
The morning of the 21st, Lucas is still begging for medical care. Quote, he requested to get all the medications he could. He was given Tylenol and more Maalox. But the video shows much of that spilled.
It spilled out on the floor and they left it there for him to crawl through back into his cell. That's basic human dignity being disregarded, stepped on. It just, it just can't go unanswered.
Giving somebody a little bit of Maalox when they're in excruciating pain and begging to go to the doctor, begging for their life, is not medical care. That's indifference.
At 11:57 that morning, video shows Lucas in his cell, falling to the floor, rolling around. An hour later, a guard steps over the still spilled Maalox and finds him unresponsive, calls for help. It's too late. Lucas is dead. An autopsy would reveal he died from that leaking ulcer.
And they did nothing. Nothing. I can't get that image out of my mind. Never will.
The family's medical experts say Lucas's condition was treatable by surgery right up until the morning he died. We first started asking the Hennepin County Sheriff for an interview about Mr. Bellamy's death last March when we learned they'd failed to comply with the Hardell-Sherrill Act, the law passed in response to our previous jail death investigations. That law requires a medical death review be done within 90 days to determine if that death could have been prevented, what steps could be taken to prevent future deaths. Jana, Sheriff Dawana Witt was unwilling to be interviewed then, and she still is.
So nearly a year later, this comes out today, and still nothing from Hennepin County?
Nothing at all. They said they won't be commenting on this.
I see. AJ, often when you're telling these stories, the families don't always have a voice, but this case is different. The Bellamy family is known to a lot of people. Their life work is giving voice to the real stories of our time.
Yeah, the dad, Lou, he founded the Penumbra Theater, Sarah. The sister, she operates it now. Lucas had acted in shows there. Sarah said something that just really stuck with me. She said her brother was not how he died. He had a big life, a big heart, and like so many in our community and nation, battled an addiction, but deserved to be treated with humanity and respect.
Absolutely. And when he's in the custody and care of Hennepin County, it doesn't matter that he battled addiction. He was due the dignity of care. And this isn't the first case. I know attorney Jeff Storms said this about jail deaths in Hennepin County.
No, there have been quite a few jail deaths in Hennepin County, and we've been reporting on jail deaths across the state, but in Hennepin County, we found over the last several years, there is just this pattern of they don't do the legally mandated welfare checks in time. They lie about doing them, claim they did them when video will clearly show they weren't done. They've lied about medical personnel seeing someone when it hadn't happened. And that's the Department of Corrections' own findings. That's not me saying that.
And when we asked today, they said no comment. Thank you, AJ.